the Salvation Army's Red Shield. It's one of the most well-known logos in the country. People can recognise it just from the shape and colour.
Can I ask you, do you know what this is?
Salvation Army.
Salvation Army.
Salvation Army.
Salvation Army.
It's a charity.
Charity.
Charity, yeah.
Charity.
Yeah.
Probably the one charity I do support.
What isn't so well known is that the Salvation Army is first of all a Christian church. In the UK, it has about 700 churches, or corps, and 1,000 full-time ministers, or officers. Every Sunday, about 50,000 people worship at Salvation Army halls up and down the country. It all started in 1865 in the East End of London, with William and Catherine Booth. They felt called to reach out to the poor with the good news of Jesus Christ. And for them, that good news wasn't just words. It was practical love and care. So almost from the start, the Salvation Army was running soup kitchens and rescue homes for women caught up in prostitution. They were providing education for children and generally doing whatever they could for the poorest of the poor. That practical Christianity, faith in action, has been the hallmark of the Salvation Army ever since, through an ever-growing range of projects and activities that reflect local needs.
I love this place. I come here a Monday, a Thursday and a Friday.
They're lovely people. People are very kind and concerned, you know.
Sometimes life can go disastrously wrong and people end up having nowhere to live. The Salvation Army doesn't judge or condemn, it just tries to help. Every day, Salvation Army lifehouses, what used to be known as hostels, are helping thousands of homeless people. And it's not just a bed for the night. They also help people recover their self-esteem, gain new skills, and move on to a better future. Cutting-edge addiction services enable people to get clean and start living again.
Coming in here, it just felt so safe, you know? There's a lot of warmth. That's the key thing in here.
The love that I was shown by the people in this place was just absolutely amazing. You know, they didn't know me from Adam, and they just, just welcomed me with open arms.
Salvation Army chaplains are at work in prisons up and down the country.
Hello, how you doing?
Hello, Duncan.
How you doing?
I'm fine. Come in.
Salvation Army canteens are a common sight at emergencies like major fires or floods, providing refreshments and a listening ear for both victims and members of the emergency services. The country's very first job centre was opened by the Salvation Army in 1890. Today, the Army helps the long-term jobless back into employment. And it provides training and job opportunities for adults with learning difficulties.
Hello, Family Tracing.
The Family Tracing Service deals with around 2,000 cases every year, reuniting on average 8 families every working day. The Army also helps the victims of human trafficking. The Salvation Army has been appointed by the UK government to manage the care of men and women rescued from sexual exploitation or slave labour. All of this work is funded through donations from the general public and through local authority and government grants. It's carried out by 4,000 staff and tens of thousands of volunteers. And it's not just here in the UK. The Salvation Army is at work all over the world. Everywhere, the aim is the same: to share the good news of Jesus and make a practical difference by putting faith into action.